Good afternoon, YouTube. Welcome back to the channel. Today I'm in Ayrshire, southwest Scotland. So I'm not in the Scottish Highlands today, I'm in the Lowlands. And where I'm going to go today is I'm going to travel from here up through or up past Dundonald Castle and then all the way up the coast to Largs. It's about an hour's ride from here. It's not such a long journey, but as usual, I'm going to try and show you some historical sites and some really interesting things. So, stay tuned. Right, folks, this part of Scotland is often overlooked. You know, this little pocket of Ayrshire. The people coming up from England, for example, may just head straight on up the motorway all the way to Glasgow. Then they'll spend their time in and around the central belt or they go up towards the north, you know, Stirling and places like that. There's a lot of nice things to see in this area as well. I'm from this area, so I tend to take it for granted. It's popular for things like golf. A lot of golf courses here, especially down towards Prestwick and Troon and things like that. It's also big on history, you know, with your Rabbi Burns and stuff like that. Sunny day! You see this little hotel here? Well, it's more of a restaurant, pub, the Cochrane. It's called the Cochrane. This whole area here used to belong to the Cochrane family. Now, Lord Cochrane was a sea captain. Probably, arguably, the most successful sea captain the Royal Navy's ever produced. Not as famous as your Lord Nelson, your Admiral Nelson's and stuff like that. This building you see behind me here is Dundonald Castle. Now, a lot of people mistakenly believe it was the home of Robert the Bruce. There was a castle here before this. This particular one was built around 1370 by Robert II, who was actually grandson of Robert the Bruce. Now, it's not difficult to see why this was built here when you look around this area. It gives a 360 degree panoramic view. It's reputed that this was a sort of hunting lodge for Robert the Bruce, which makes sense because he was Earl of Carrick before he ever became King of the Scots. So Robert the Bruce would have had a home around Killeen. So whilst the Bruce and his descendants were undoubtedly the most famous residents of this little castle, they weren't the only ones. But when we get to Largs, I'll come back to Dundonald Castle, you know. Craig. This is the Isle of Arran. Down here we've got Troon. Now people have got a tendency to just sort of skip straight on through these little towns. You know, Ardeer, Saltcoats, Ardrossan. As I was about to do actually, you know, skip straight along the bypass. They've actually got some nice little shore fronts, you know, little sea fronts. We'll just skip on down and have a look. It's for a day out, I guess. What a night! Absolutely glorious. You've got to try and make the best of it. Especially in Scotland, because the weather's about to change. You know, September now, once we start to get into October, November, it's a whole different ballgame. You do get some really nice weather in the winter, you get these cold, crisp, clear mornings. But more often than not, we get a lot of rain. Of course, snow. But I guess riding around in the snow might make for some interesting off-road videos in the near future. I'm looking forward to it actually. Built for all roads. Little Himalayan. But across in here, this is where you get the ferry over to Arran. Now Arran, the Isle of Arran really dominates the west coast of Scotland here. That's the entire Ayrshire coastline. Yeah, it's just a big mountain sticking out the sea. It's beautiful actually. It's kind of referred to as Scotland in miniature. If you go there, it's well worth a visit. It takes about an hour on the ferry. There's the Arran ferry there. It's 6:15, so we've got a couple of hours of daylight yet. But I'll tell you something, it's going to be a hell of a sunset tonight. The sunset's over Arran actually. So I fully intend to see most of it. Hopefully capture it on video. Should be nice. For the west of Scotland, this is quite an exclusive postcode. But it's not difficult to see why. Virtually every single one of these houses will have a sea view. Stunning. But what a view as well. Out over towards Arran. Even in the winter it's stunning. The police. What are they doing down here? Seriously. Come on. We're down for a view, no doubt. Get back to town where crime's happening. Not hanging about down the beach. During the Iron Age there was a dun here, but the particular castle you see here was built in the mid-1300s by the Boyd family, and this area was given to them by Robert the Bruce because of their support during the Wars of Independence. So you're looking at the same sort of time period as Dundonald. Let's go to Largs. I'm trying to beat the sunset. I've got about an hour before it's fully dark. This is where we're headed. Alright folks, you guessed that there was a battle here, but this one was a little bit unusual. This behind me here, this little pencil, that's actually a memorial to the battle, and it happened here in 1263. And this was a battle between the Scots and the Norwegian Vikings. It's fair to say the Vikings had been a big problem across the British Isles for about 500 years. Certainly it was about 500 years that they had been invading different parts of Scotland. And by the time 1263 came along, they actually controlled most of the Outer Hebrides and the Inner Hebrides, your Orkneys and things like that. Scottish king at that time was Alexander III. Now, when he came to the throne, he was only 7 years old. But like his father, he had grand ambitions, and he really wanted to regain control of the Hebridean islands and all of the islands that were controlled by the Norwegian Vikings. So like any good Scottish king, he invaded Skye, which was a it's a Scottish island now, but at that time it was controlled by the Vikings. And he wreaked havoc there, to be honest, with the Scottish troops. Now, the King of Norway, the Norwegian Viking king, Håkon, was really, really upset about this. So in early 1263, he sent a huge force of ships and men and material to this area. And Alexander III, knowing that he was in trouble, sent envoys to the Norwegian king to sue for peace. But really all he was doing was biding for time. The Norwegians really wanted to bring the Scots to heel. So they sent over 1,000 ships into this bay here. Now if you can imagine 1,000 ships here,
in 1263. It's really difficult to imagine it. But what Alexander III wanted to do was he wanted to delay the Norwegians up until the autumn, till this time of year, September, because he knew that it would be a huge risk for the Vikings with the longboats to be out at sea at this time of year. See this island behind me here? Haakon camped his forces there because it was felt to be too great a risk to bring his ships to the Scottish mainland here. But late in September, this time of year, there was a huge storm and it blew some of the ships over onto the shore here. So Haakon sent some men over to try and retrieve the ships, because obviously they're extremely valuable. So if you can imagine those Viking longboats that have been blown up onto the shore here, the Scots were really looking to try and trap the Vikings. So they sent a force of about 200 Scots here, but there were slingers and archers. Now, wasn't a huge force, but it was enough to harry the men here. So they were hiding behind the longboats that they were trying to retrieve. So the Viking king, Haakon, he fell for the trap. He sent a larger force, including himself. He came over here with his longboats to try and protect these men. So when they came over here, the Scots were nowhere to be found. One of the Viking leaders called Ogmund, he set up camp just up on this hill up here. And that was to protect the forces down here who were trying to retrieve these boats. Early the next morning though, Ogmund woke up to discover a huge force of Scots marching up the coast here, heading up through a large yacht haven behind me. Now, the Scots were led by a man called Alexander of Dundonald. Remember that castle we went to at the beginning of this video? Now, you guessed it. So, Dundonald sent a force of Scots troops up onto the hill there to attack Ogmund, who realised that he was going to be surrounded and potentially cut off, started to retreat down the hill here. Now the Scots had an advantage, they had some heavy cavalry with them. So that orderly retreat started to become a rout as they came down here towards the beaches, and the Vikings here started to panic. However, they set up a line behind me here to meet the Scots, but essentially it ended up in defeat. So this was a real disaster for the Vikings. They got on what was left of the longboats here and they started to retreat. Now, Haakon left behind men and ships. Now, the Vikings were essentially done for the season. They wanted to get out of here before winter set in, because this campaign was turning into a real disaster for them. So Haakon sailed way back up the Scottish coast again, all the way back up to Orkney. But he intended to come back early in the next year. Unfortunately for him, he fell ill over the winter and he died. So there was a new king in Norway, Magnus, and he agreed that he would give all of these Scottish islands back, or all of these islands that are now part of Scotland, back to the Scottish crown for a fee. They were going to pay an annual, like almost like a lease or a rent. Very, very soon the Scots decided they weren't going to pay that money. The Vikings did nothing about it. They never came back. And that was it for the Vikings, folks. They never really came back to Scotland in any real force. It'd been a real issue for the Scots for over 500 years, but this battle here was a real turning point in the history of both the nations, both Scotland, which was still Alba at that time, and Norway.
So, as I'm sure you can imagine, Largs is very popular with bikers. And it's simply because this coast road here is lovely. People like to buzz up and down here. Anyway, that's it for this video, guys. I really hope you liked it. If you did, give me a thumbs up, subscribe down below, maybe even hit that notification bell so you know the next time I upload another video to YouTube. If you want to watch another install or maybe another tips and tricks video, have a look at one of these here, and I'll see you in the next one.